A warm welcome for everyone to the session number 13 in the part of React Learning series. Handling user input with forms is the cornerstone of many web applications. Applications use forms to enable users to log in, to update a profile, to enter sensitive information, and to perform many other data entry tasks. Unlike Angular and AngularJS that gives form validation out of the box, we have to handle forms ourselves in React. That includes complications like how to get form values, how to manage form state, how to validate forms on the fly, and how to show validation messages. In this session, we will understand how to build forms in React. In HTML, form elements such as input element, text area element, and select element typically maintain their own state and update it based on user input. In React, state of these input elements is typically kept in state property of the components and only updated with setState method. An input form element whose value is controlled by React in this fashion is called as controlled input or controlled component. The alternative is uncontrolled input, where form data is handled by the DOM itself. We will use ref to get value of this input and perform operations on this data. We have discussed both of these ways of handling input data in our previous sessions. Though uncontrolled inputs are simplest way to implement the form inputs, but they are not powerful enough to build real-world applications. In this demonstration, we will use controlled inputs, and definitely we all will understand the importance of them by the end of this video. To understand things in practical, let's open index.js file.
Within this index.js file, let us create a class called as employee component, which extends react.component class. Let us add a constructor to this class, and this constructor accepts properties as an argument and pass these properties to the base class constructor using super keyword. Let us add a state object and add a property called as id and initialize this to empty. Now let us go ahead and implement render method. Within this render method, we will return a div container. Let us add a h2 tag and let's display the text as new employee form. Let us add a form tag. We will place a paragraph tag and a label employee ID, and in order to allow users to enter employee ID, we have to place an input type is equals to text, and we will assign a name to this, and let's say the name as ID, and we wanted to bind the value to this text box. We get the value using state object this dot state dot ID. And let's call a function whenever there is a change in the input using onChange attribute. onChange is equals to, let's say the function name as this.changeHandler. Let me format this. Now we will go ahead and implement a function called as changeHandler. This changeHandler function will accept an input, and that input gives us the information about the respective text box. Within this function, we save the input text box value into our state object using this.setState method. So we say this dot set state, and here we have to get the ID value. We get that ID value using e dot. We use an attribute called as target, and on that attribute we use value to get the value of the respective text box. So whenever we enter some text within this text box, for every change on the input of this text box, we are calling a function called as change handler, and we are updating the value to our state object using this dot set state method. Let's create another function called as onCreateEmployee, and we create it as an arrow function, and within this function we log the ID value onto the console. We get the ID value using this.state.id. Now let's go to our render method and let us place a button, and on click of this button let us call the function what we have created just now, this.onCreateEmployee, and let's give the text as create. Now we will call this employee component and we will render this component. I have the code handy and I am pasting it here. Now let us save these changes. Let us navigate to the browser, and we can see a simple form is being displayed which has a text box where we can enter employee ID. Now let us enter employee ID, and I enter employee ID as 101, and let's click on this create. Now when we click on this create, we are logging this employee ID into the console. Let us open developer tools using F12, and now let's click on this button, and we can see the ID value is displayed here. So if we see here, On this input, we are calling a function called as changeHandler during onChange event of this text box. So whenever there is a change in the value of this text box, we are updating our state. Now we will extend our form by providing more inputs for employee name, location and salary. In order to save these input values into our state object, let us add a new employee object to our state and let us add properties like ID, name, location and salary to our employee object. Now let us go to our form, and if we have a look at the value of this input element, we have previously assigned this.state.id, but now we don't have ID available directly on the state object, so we have to change it to this.state.employee.id. Now we will copy this and we repeat the same for employee name, location and salary. As we see here, I have added inputs for employee name, location and salary. If we observe this code, we are calling the same function for onChange event on every input element, and it is the right way to do so. That is because we cannot create 20 functions if we have 20 inputs. Within this changeHandler function, we have to handle the onChange event for all the inputs and update the state object using setState method. So let us go ahead and do that. Now let's go to changeHandler function. So first let us get the name of the element on which user is making the change. Using e.target. We use an attribute called as name, and let us get the value as well, e.target.value. Now to this setState method, we will pass employee object, and that employee object should contain all the previous property values plus the current changed property and its value. We get all the previous property values by using spread operator. So we use three dots, this dot, state dot, employee, comma, plus we should add a new property to this employee object, and name of this property will be the input element name which we have obtained here, and this property will hold the value of that respective input element. So we say square brackets name and we assign the value. Whenever user makes a change on any of the input elements, we are updating that data to our state object using this.setState method. Now let's go to our onCreateEmployee function, and instead of logging the ID to our console, let us log the employee object. Let us save these changes. Let us navigate to the browser. As we can see, we have employee ID, name, location, salary inputs. Let us go and enter these inputs. Let's click on this create button, and we can see the employee object is being displayed here. And this object has properties like ID, name, location, and salary. Now we have understood how to create a simple form using React. But to this form, we want to add validations. We want to keep track of the visited fields by the user, and we have to handle form submission as well. As we have discussed in the beginning of this video, React do not provide all these features by default. We have few libraries available for us using which we can achieve all of these functionalities. Formik is one of the popular library available, and we will use this library for building powerful forms in this React application. But remember, Formik is also built on the same principles of controlled components and managing state. That is what we have learnt until now. Formik is a small group of React components and functions used for building forms in React and React Native. Formik helps us with three most important activities. First one is to get the values in and out of the form state. Second one is doing the validation and displaying the error messages. And third one is handling form submission. Let us navigate to our Node.js command prompt. Let us stop the current project which is running successfully. So we use Ctrl+C as the command to stop it, and it is asking us to terminate the job. Let us press Ctrl+C again. Now let us run a command called as npm install formik space --save. This command installs Formik library into our demo project. Let us run this command. After it is successfully installed, let us use cls command to clear the screen, and let us run this project using npm start command. Now let us switch back to Visual Studio Code. Let us delete the employee component class which we have created. Now let's import useFormik function from Formik library. So we say import useFormik from Formik. Let us create employee component, and in this context we will create our employee component as a function component. We write an arrow function. Let us call our useFormik function and assign it to a variable called as Formik. And to this function, we will pass an object and this object will have a property called as initial values, and we will pass an object which contains properties like ID, name, location and salary. And to this object, let us pass another property called as onSubmit, and this onSubmit is a function, and this function will be called whenever the form is submitted. This function will be receiving the form's input data as a parameter, and let us display the form's data in an alert json.stringify, and we'll pass values. When the form is submitted, this function will be called, and within this function we are displaying the form's data into an alert. Let us return a div container from this function component. Let us add a h2 and let us display a text as new employee form. Let us add a form tag onSubmit is equals to, we will pass the object what we have created. Using that object we will access a function called as handleSubmit. So this function will be called whenever we submit the form. Now let us place our inputs within this. Let's place a paragraph tag, label HTML for is equals to, let's say ID, employee ID. Now let us place an input element whose type is text. Input type is equals to text. Name is equals to, we give the name as ID, and we will also pass ID. ID is equals to ID, and we bind the value to this input using value is equals to, we get the value from our Formik object, Formik dot. We have an attribute called as values through which we can access values of our form dot. We have a property called as ID, and on this input let us handle onChange event. OnChange is equals to, we say Formik is the object what we have created dot, it has a method called as handleChange. If we look at the code what we have written, we have passed our form's initial values and a submission function to this useFormik function, and this function is returning an object. Using this object we are accessing handleSubmit, using which we can handle the form submission, and we are accessing the form values using formik.values, and we are accessing handleChange, which is a change handler which will be triggered for every input change. And now we will repeat the same for employee name, location and salary. Now let us place a button and type is equals to submit, and we will give create as the text, and we have the code using which we are rendering our component to the DOM. Let us save these changes. Let us navigate to the browser, and we can see our form is being displayed here. Let us enter some data into this, and now let us click on this create button, and we can see our data is displayed in a JSON object, and this data can be passed to our web API as well, as we had discussed in our last session. Now we have seen how do we create a simple form, how do we place input elements within the form, and how do we retrieve the data of that form. We will discuss more about doing the validations of this form in our next video. Thank you for watching this video and have a great day.